Now we are supposed to solve this problem, that is your running sum of the array. So consider the numbers that are present in the list, the array is your 20, 10, 70, 40 and 80. So how can we find the running sum? Your first element will be written as it is. So let us say the name of this list is your LT. Okay, so the first element will be 20 as it is. The next element will be sum of this 10 and 20. So 20 plus 10, that is 30. Then next one, so running sum, 20 plus 10, that is 30, 30 plus 70, that is your 100. Then next, so all this 20 plus 10 plus 70 plus 40, that becomes your 140, and the next element, that's your 220. So this is your running sum, and this should be present in this array named answer, and both of this array will have length n. So if your this LT array is having the length n, then this answer array should have the length, the same length, that is n, right? So in this case, if I just mark the indices, index 0, index 1, 2, 3, 4, and let me represent this index by variable I. Okay, so solve the problem by yourself, pause the video and try to solve it. Alright, so let us see the approach, that how can we solve it, right? So what is the first thing that we should be doing? In my 0th index of this array, I'll put the first element, that is your 0th element of this list. So if I write here LT of 0, so this 20 will be assigned to this answer of 0, right? So consider this is your answer array, right? So first of all, 20 will be pushed here due to this line. Now if you observe this, when you move to the next element, right, in the loop, so you will traverse the loop after this line, you will be starting this value of I from 1. Why 1? Because already first element is inserted, that is 20, right? So I to n minus 1, right? In this case, if I write this, let us say answer of I, so first of all, this 0th index of answer is filled already, 20. Now if you see index 1, in this index 1, what I should be putting, that is 30. That means the previous element in answer plus the current element in my list. So which is the previous element in answer? So if the current element in answer is I, then the previous element will be, so if this number, let us say I, what is previous of I? That is I minus 1. Yes or no? So here I can write answer of I minus 1, the previous element. So if you see, your I is 1. Now answer of 1, this assignment operator, answer of 1 minus 1, that is 0. So that is your 20. I will just add with the current element, that is list of I. So if I write here LT of I, so I is now 1, right? So it is how much? 10. So 20, this is your 20 and this is your 10. So 20 plus 10 will be 30, right? So 30 is filled now. It is matching, you can see here. Now in the next index, that is index 2, again your value of I becomes 2 now, right? So at this index 2, what is the value of this answer of I minus 1? So 2 minus 1, that is 1, so that is a 30. So this is your 30. Then list of I, the value of I is 2, it is 70. 30 plus 70 is 100, so 100 will be placed in this index 2. In the similar way for index 3, so what is the value of I now? I is now 3. So this is your 3 minus 1. So answer of 3 minus 1, that is 2. And in index 2 of this answer, what is the value? 100, right? So 100 as it is, plus list of I. So list of I, what is the value of I now? It's 3. It is 40. So 100 plus 40 is how much? 140. Again, 140 will be placed in this index 3. Now, if you check at index 4, so at index 4, if you observe now, answer of I minus 1, 4 minus 1, that is 3. Answer of 3, what is the value? 140. So 140 will be taken from this answer. And then list of I, what is the value of I now? 4. So that is 80. 140 plus 80, what is the value of this? That is 220. So 220 will be filled here. And when finally this value of I becomes 5, so condition fails, and then you come out of the loop finally. And if you observe now, this is your running sum, right? So this is the idea. Let us convert this idea into code. Okay. So I'll just go to my editor. First of all, I'll take int n. So let me generate a message for the user to enter the value of n. That is the size of the array, right? So using scene statement, let me read the value of n. Now what I can do, first of all, I need to create the array, right? So int star ar, or let me write here lt, assignment operator new int, and here size will be n. Fine. Now I can just fill the elements one by one. So before that, I'll just generate a message, enter the values, right? Enter the values. Okay, follow. So here let me put slash n for the new line, semicolon. Now I need a loop to read the values, I starting from 0, I less than n, and here I should increment by 1, so I plus plus, or you can write I plus assigns 1. Anyways, so here I can write standard scene read all the elements, that is list of I. Okay, finally, after reading the values, after reading all the values, what we need to do, we need to calculate that running sum. So for that, I'll do this with the help of a function. So int star, why I'm writing this int star, I'll explain you. The name of the function, RS, that stands for running sum. Okay, and here int, let's say the array name is, okay, let me write here t. Okay, and then this symbol, and along with the array, I need to pass the size of the array. Okay, int n, let us say. So now within this function, this is a function declaration. Now we'll define the function for calculating the running sum. So I'll be writing here int star rs. So basically this, by this int star, the return type is int star, means it will receive an address. Okay, it will return an address. This function will return an address. Okay, so here int, so what is the name here, t comma int n, the size of the array, right? So now first of all, let me create one array here, that is int, let us say integer star answer. Okay, assignment operator here int, let us say n. So that is the size of this array, actually the old array. Now what we can do, for, so before starting the loop, if you see the list of zero, the zeroth element, we are supposed to assign to answer of zero. So answer of zero, assignment operator, list of, so this list is received by which variable, that is your t, right? This array. So t of zero, done. Once we have done this operation, now I should start from one, I less than n, and I should increment every time by 1. Now if you observe here, we have written answer of I, assignment operator, answer of the previous element, right? That is I minus 1 plus the current element of whom, of the list, and this list is represented here by t, so t of I. And finally, after coming out of the loop, I will return this array, that is answer. Okay, so this is my function rs, which will calculate the running sum. Now I'll just come to my this main function. Now what I can do is, let me call the function, that is rs, and so this one I'm going to hold it in a new array. So let me write here int star p, assignment operator, let me call the function rs, and let me pass the function, so lt, and then size of the function, sorry, size of the array. Now here, so once this perform the calculation of the running sum, okay, so that array will be returned. Now we are supposed to print the array. So for int I starting from 0, right, I less than n, and value of I should increment by 1. Okay, so let me write here standard cout, the value, that is, let me write here list of I, let us see what happens, list of I, and then here slash t for the tab character for large spaces. Okay, and finally, once this loop is over, we'll just come out and print a new line here. So standard cout, standard endl. Okay, so now here I'll just compile it. Okay, so here an error is there, yes, definitely, because I have not put this new keyword here, right? So this new keyword is useful for allocating the memory in heap. Okay, so how can we forget that? anyways, small mistake, dot slash test. So enter the value of n. So let me enter 5 values, okay. And what were those values? 20, 10, 70, 40. So 20, then 10, then 70, 40, and then 80. So if I hit enter, let us see what happens. So what we are getting? 10, 20, okay, sorry, 20, 10, 70, 40, 80. The same element, right? The same array we are getting. So actually, whatever array is returned, that is this answer is returned and stored within this P actually. So that is why instead of printing this LT, we are supposed to print P. Okay, now we can observe the change. So if I just compile this again, so whenever you make change in your code, you should recompile it, right? Now if I run it, let me put the 10 values, that is 5 values, 20, then 10, then 70, then 40, and then finally 80. So you can see the running sum now, 20, 30, 100, 140, 220, right? So let me explain that how this particular function is working, right? So first of all, I'll just consider this main function first of all. This main. So let me just cut out the piece of code of this main. This main, and after that, I'll take my this function RS. So add to a new page. And then along with it, I'm reducing the size little. I'll just read out, you will understand everything. And then I'll just cut out the code for this function, that is RS, right? So now I can just take from this line number 26 to 35 and add to the current page, okay? So now let us try to understand what is happening, okay? So your program begins the execution from main, then your n is allocated in the stack frame of main, right? So let me do one thing. Let me draw the stack here, right? And this is the heap memory. So this is my stack memory and this is my heap memory, right? HEAP, heap. Okay, now what happens? Your operating system calls the main function. So in your stack, the main function gets some memory, right? Some memory is allocated for the main function. Now this variable n is allocated, right? And once the user enters the value of n, that is stored inside this variable n, that is, let us say 5. Now what happens due to this line, this LT, the pointer LT is allocated some amount of memory in your this main function stack frame. So let us say, after that I have written here assignment operator new int n. So due to this new keyword, what happens in the heap memory? What happens? Your memory is allocated for how many integers? N. N is 5. So 5 blocks will be there. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then fifth block will be somewhere here. This is your fifth block, okay? Now what happens? Due to this lines, that is your 13 to 16, you know, the inputs will be taken, right? So what were the inputs? And let me tell you, whatever is the base address of this array, let us say 4K, this address will be assigned to this LT, right? So basically we can say this LT is pointing this array that is allocated in heap memory, right? Now what happens once the input is read, that is your, what were the inputs if I remember, as far as, so here it is 20, then next one was 10, then 70, 40, right? 20, 10, 70, 40, and then 80. All right, so this is your 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, this is not required. Anyways, this is drawn by mistake. Let me erase this part. Okay, so this will confuse you, that's why I'll just erase this part. Okay, fine, now it is all right. Now if you observe, after that this line number 17, that is int star p. So again in your main function, your this main function stack frame, this variable p is allocated with some amount of memory. So what happens now if you observe, this is the function call, right? RS. So the function call is, the main function calls this function RS. Now on top of this main function, right, your RS function, RS gets called in this stack, right? Now what happens in the stack frame of this RS, what happens, this T receives the address of this list. So basically your T is a variable in your this RS function, which receives the address of this LT. So what is the value of LT? LT is the address, right? That is 4K. So this address 4K is copied to this T, Is that clear? Okay. Now what is happening here? If you observe, t gets the value 4k and this n is copied exactly as it is. So what is the value of n? N was 5. So in this case, this is your n here. So this n is for this function rs. Okay. What is the value? That is 5. Now basically what is happening? This t is also pointing to your same array that is present in the heap memory, right? Now you see, next is this answer. This is your answer pointer. This answer pointer, what happens? Again, we are having this assignment operator, new int n. So again, in your heap memory, somewhere in the heap memory, it is going to allocate some amount of memory. That is, n is 5. So 5 blocks will be allocated. Block 0, so 0 index 0, index 1, index 2, index 3, and finally index 4. Now what is happening here? The t of 0. So t is pointing here, right, in this address 4k, and let us say this answer is pointing to the address, let us say 8k, right? So this is your 8k. So you can see that answer is different array, and this t and this lt is pointing to the same array, right? Now t of 0, so what is t of 0? 20. So 20 is copied to this answer of 0. 20 is copied here, right? Now your I starts from 1. Okay, I starts from 1. So this I will be allocated here in the stack frame of this RS. So I starts from 1, fine. Now I'll just check the condition, that is 1 is less than n. Yes. Now I'll come here, answer of 1, I is 1. So in this index, right, in this index, that is answer of 1, assignment operator, answer of I minus 1. So what is I now? 1. 1 minus 1, 0. So answer of 0, what is the element? That is 20. So 20 will be taken, then plus sign, and t of I. So what is the value of I now? It is 1. So t of I, that is, t is pointing this 4k address, right? So this is 10. So now 20 plus 10, how much it is? 30. So 30 will be stored in answer of 1. So 30 is stored here, right? Now next what happens? Your this value of I increments to 2. So I becomes 2 now. Now if you observe, this condition is still true. Now this array, that is answer of 2. In this answer of 2, we'll put the data, right? Assignment operation, I minus 1. What is the value of I now? It is 2, if you observe. So 2 minus 1, that is 1. Answer of 1, how much is present? 30. So 30 will be taken plus t of I. So t of I, what is the value of I now? 2. So that is 70. 30 plus 70, how much it is? It is 100. So this 100 will be assigned to this location. In the similar way, your 140 will be filled here, and then finally 220 will be filled here, and then this function will just return back here. So this, the memory that is allocated for this RS will be deallocated. Okay, so everything that was related to this RS will be erased off, right? This will be popped off from the stack frame. That is the stack frame of your RS function. And finally, if you observe, this pointer p will get the address of this answer. So what is the address of this answer? That is 8k. So this 8k will be assigned to this pointer p. So if you observe in the last code that we have written, when we are printing this lt of I, so lt is pointing to your original array, not the modified array, right? But this 8k, this address 8k is pointing to your modified array. Now when you print this p of I, it prints all the elements from 20 to 220, right? 20, 30, 100, 140 and 220, and hence your running sum is printed. So this was the memory level view. Anyways, I hope this logic and the memory level explanation is clear to you. Okay, so the program was pretty straightforward, right? Only the explanation went very long. Anyways,